says he won't be taking them lightly today. And it is an afternoon for Watford, the Hornets to cast their premiership problems aside and relish the match that for many of this young team may not come around too often. Marlon King, it's a real surprise that he's on the bench for Watford today. He's been out for such a long time. He was talking about playing in the final if they got there. Well, he apparently is ready. I'm not sure how good he is, but he has been back in training after his knee operation. And of course, well, he can be a very useful man to bring on with his goal-scoring reputation. His eye for a goal. Alan Smith at the sharp end for United. Tapping with Rooney, with the likes of Giggs and, of course, Ronaldo. Coming up to join him as often as they can, and it will be pretty often too, I'm sure. Watford's game plan will be to contain them where they can, get in their faces, just as they did with Chelsea a few weeks ago, and they nearly caused an upset then. Only a last-minute goal. Only for the Blues to beat them. There is Ronaldo, wearing number 7, of course, for Manchester United. He played so well in the game at Old Trafford against Roma in midweek. So did Rooney, they're all on song, of course. It was a fantastic performance all round. It will take some beating and some living up to. Always brought to Edwin van der Sar. Pretty much the number one, despite one or two jittery moments lately. And by Carlisle, who's been preferred then to Dan Shittu in the centre. Alongside the American Demerit. Something of a surprise there, although Carlisle did come in for his first premiership start on Monday and did well. Shittu was still expected to start today. Carlisle got the vote instead, and Shittu again hasn't taken it too well. No question of an injury, just a straight choice by the manager. Fully impressed with Clark Carlisle's contribution against Portsmouth. Quiet. Such a strange game, isn't it? Football. Dalton Pompey, of course, beat Manchester United just a couple of days earlier. As you credit him. Stewart coming in very strongly and aggressively on Wayne Rooney. Looking to dish it out as well. That promises to be quite a contest. Involving Rooney at the merit. And with Alan Smith, who can certainly put himself about as well. Only a handful of starts. Returning from injury. A reassuring take then from Richard Lee. After not the only man in the world, I think he was pleased when he heard the draw, but it looked to be that Ben Foster wouldn't be playing, that he would be. This is a Hungarian Priskin. On the left. Jack is in a shuffling attack in the absence of his front-line defenders. Still such talented players in reserve, as they have been underlining in recent games. Well, Richard Lee has played twice against Manchester United already this season. He's led in 6 goals in those 2 Premiership fixtures. Andy Boothroyd, and Keith Birkinshaw, you might recognise an outside of there, and Tottenham manager. Which a father figure, and consultant for Andy Boothroyd, the young manager, who's finding how tough life can be at the top this season. He'll take a premiership up in his first full campaign in charge, of course. Not put up from the championship. Is naturally left-footed, but on the right then. Under the game plan today. It's Jordan Stewart, left back in this Watford formation. There's Carlisle. this long-term injury before his return against Portsmouth earlier in the week. Brown for United. And it's Hetzer who's been saying this week how desperate he is to play in an FA Cup final. Lovely carry, short-footed. A lovely kick there by Giggs. Evra to bend it in. Just as unpopular to me though, to hang it right back. Not really favour left as much as he does. Look for Will encourage Stewart to get forward down that left side whenever he can. Goals. They really closed him down. Made it by Giggs. Another chance. And Rooney again. They really have got to close them down quick or what, but deny them space. Saying that this week, it's a one-off, you never know. deep down he must be fearing the worst. Here's Tommy Smith. It's a decent movement here, and they've got a few up two in support. Heads over the header away. Now Ronaldo celebrating this new contract. Not the challenge on him, which has left him limping. Really in some discomfort. There's Puskin's layoff. Chambers with the ball dent in. And now a free kick to United. And a foul on Rooney by Mariappa. He's playing at right back with James Chambers pushing up into midfield. Evra surging forward for the Red Devils. And to tidy up. They need to clear away somewhat hastily. Hold their nerve here for a bit, try and gain some composure, Watford, and stem the red tide, if they can. Scores. Chambers was in the way, though. And Smith going to ground. Tackled by Alan Smith, Ronaldo. Smith's ball in towards Rooney! And Lee just about got there first. But he's in the mood. And it's a menacing move, Wayne Rooney. Super tackle then by Alan Smith on his namesake, Tommy. Smith, who was a scorer in midweek, his first goal for 15 months or so. And Charlie Ferguson has been praising his attitude, his patience. Just waiting his chance again, which he has certainly got now. And one or two injuries. The return to Sweden of Henrik Larsson. In time, the free kick has gone against Priskin up front for Watford. The jump by Rooney and then Alan Smith. And his confidence, no question, is returning. And we are beginning to see again now the player they thought they'd signed. He had that long-term injury, long spell out, Alan Smith. After the cup, during the cup tie with Liverpool, some 14 months ago, it's been a long way back for him. He's only really just recently been discovering his best form again. Very much in the frame, as far as the new man, the manager is concerned. It's like having a new player. To contain him, that's the question for Watford. Not to mention Ronaldo and Scholes at Smith. And yeah, they've been so quick to punish Watford with the early goal. Here's Hatzo. Carrick, who's been playing with such authority. Good jump by Demeritz. Here's Ronaldo, can't skip free this time though. Goes Scholes. That was a foul. That was his strong point. Tackling Paul Scholes. As his disciplinary record will emphasise. Certainly went into the back end of Gavin Marr. Ready by Brown. Martin in the thick of things again. Along with Damien Francis, they went for the same ball, really. Smith. Mariappa was on his way back to dispossess him. Good leap again by Hatzo. The flag's up for offside. It's not one, but two Watford front players, including Priskin here. You understand me, I think it's taken as well, it's taken the time to settle in the English game after coming from Hungary. And he got his first Premiership goal on Monday. That will give him, I'm sure, a huge lift. take on. Now Fox, probably about three defenders if he can. Squeezed on to Smith. And it was Stuart the Steward who just got back in the nick of time then. He might just be the busier of the two goalkeepers this afternoon, Richard Lee. Defenders. Scholes. 15 minutes gone. And United very much with the other hand so far. Wayne Rooney with the opening goal. Here's Giggs to Evra. Now Carrick. Evra again. Not tight enough on him. And Chambers clashing with Hetze. Here's Rooney. Again, decent delivery. Still not to can't get it away. Not at the first attempt, anyway. That was Carrick back in. Ronaldo. And Carlisle stuck with his guts well there to defy the Portuguese international. So Adam Ferguson saying he's the best player in the world at the moment. I think nobody could argue with that. Smith with the free kick. And he didn't want to cope too well with that, in truth. The merit suddenly on the scene. And he scored the opening goal on that famous day in the playoff final. And they overcame Leeds United to earn their place in the Premiership this season. There's Tommy Smith. Third FA Cup semi-final, second for Watford. Stuart. I think that's underlining his prowess in the air, the Argentine. This is Marlo, back into the mix again. Promising spell this for Watford. Beginning to find their feet a little in the semi-final. Ago. He's fought his way back from that, and he is now playing in the semi-final again, as he did back in 2004. Thank you. enthusiastic and innovative management skills. Style on Tuesday. Rooney, who was among the scorers, of course, in the seven. Lovely layoff there, two scores. By Evra. United hammering on the door again. And they're gathered in by Lee. Bruce Chambers. As he tried to curl it just inside the far post. But he does look a talent. There's a scorching drive that saw off Plymouth's challenge at the quarterfinals. And what the fans will remember, it was our goal that they counted for in the semis back in 84 when they went all the way to Wembley. George Riley, remember him? Older viewers may well do, he got the winner. Here at Villa Park. John Barnes crosses on the court. Mariata. Check was going to ground, they didn't appear to be clipped then. That's safe. Shot on his ankle again, I think. So a free kick to Watford, who have lost each of the last eight meetings now with Manchester United. They've been there for 21 years. He has to control that then. Van der Sar. Stewart is teasing Evra, his opposite number. Come out too convincingly. The Dutch international, still the Dutch number one incidentally, he played in their recent international. Maybe it was Ferdinand who was in his way, there did seem to be a shove in any case. From Tomas Priskin. Kushak is on the bench if needed, as he was in the last round against Middlesbrough. If Van der Sar can't continue. So I think he dropped out of the last minute during the warm-up for the first game against Middlesbrough. Of course, United needed a replay for overcoming the Southgate's team. Foster, the man missing out for Watford today, will be returning to Old Trafford next season as backup, presumably, to the Dutchman. Not sure where that's going to leave Thomas Kuschak. There is some talk, though, that Kuschak might be going to Vicarage Road. Watch the space, as they say. This season has brought his team level and suddenly changed the whole mood around Villa Park. Watford won, Manchester United won. Hamer Bouazza on 26 minutes. Ronaldo. Almost an instant response from Alan Smith. Survived. Goal number 7 for him this season, the second then in this competition. All the noise at the moment is coming from the whole plan. From the Watford fans. Suddenly their game are back in this semi-final. As well, here is Ronaldo, and they're back in front. Just for a couple of minutes after concealing at the other end. That's the measure of this team. Fantastic reply by Manchester United. They had Watford really stretched here. Rooney's run. Time to look up. Lee was a little unlucky there. And it rolled invitingly into Cristiano Ronaldo's path for his 21st goal of the season. Not bad for a winger. But he'll be the first to pay tribute then, as will to Alec Ferguson, to the run of Rooney as he powered away, leaving defenders trailing in his wake.
Pleading with
him to have a go as he did on Monday. Certainly obliged. But here's Ronaldo now, launching the counter away. Away come United. Lovely ball back into his path again. Ronaldo, that's a great tackle though. Terrific tackle from Demera. And such a crucial one for his team. Ronaldo was away. And at times he really is unplayable. Jay Demerit, the American defender, American international as he is now, very much trumps a fantastic challenge to deny him a route to goal. Nothing wrong with that. He certainly played the ball first. Perfectly timed. Really relishing this occasion, I'm sure. Jay Demerit, who came to Watford for non-league football a little while back. Ray Lewington signed him. And he really has flourished under Eddie Boothroyd to cement his place. Hetze, half an hour gone, it's been lively, and eventful too. United dominating, but Watford certainly giving themselves a glimmer of hope, and more than that at the time with the equaliser, after Rooney had put United in front, but then Rooney setting up Ronaldo for the second, to put them back in the driving seat, the treble chasers. Rooney had a go for goal then, with Lee so far out of his territory. It was worth a shot. Lee, who apparently turned the television off the other night, was watching the Manchester United game against Roma. Went up to 3 or 4, as I've said it others. And a slip tonight. Thanks for the corner, should be the keeper's. By Bouazza, only as far as Patrice Evra for United. Restored. There's Hetze. Smith has pulled out wide here. Aided by Rooney. Now Carrick. Number 16 shirt, vacated by Roy Keane. Such gusto these days. According to his manager, here's Hetze. He just tempted for a moment, but stayed at home, and wisely so. He might not let it go, you know. Analyzed by the United fans, and no wonder. Just for a moment, he was dreaming. Yet, and they've shown the spirit that he was calling for. You know, there'll be so many attacking options. Not the need to remain fully concentrated, fully focused throughout the understand any chance at all of going on to the final. Bouazza to Chambers. Ferdinand, who nudged it away to Rooney. Alan Smith. That's superbly there by his teammate. Gabriel Hetze. Two scores, three times an FA Cup winner. Passing, as he did against Roma. Two great finishes as well. Damien Francis. What the team, we've certainly had to be completely outplayed, and certainly not completely overawed either. So he testifies. Mariata. Smith changing in typically abrasive fashion. Francis then for Watford. Puskin after this one, and he's forced a corner too, off Rio Ferdinand. Off goes Jay Domenech. along with Carlisle, his central defensive partner. Looking to give United some problems back there. Rises corner. Superbly then. So many gifted footballers, gifted individuals. It is in any case a very strong team. Manchester United. Hetze from Ronaldo's pass. Problems looming here for Watford. Well, not for long. Look up Smith. Face and a twinkle in his boots. He has been breathtaking this season. Thank you. Richardson. Richardson on the bench. Looking at Solskjaer. Jared Fletcher. Take his place. The other option might have been young Craig Cathcart. He's only 18, he is a defender. The former youth team players. He's an under 19 international with Northern Ireland. He was on the bench for the win over Middlesbrough in the replay in the last round. Not called upon at the moment though, it's Darren Fletcher instead. Into the last 5 minutes of the first half. As Brown, Hetze has gone into the middle. And Fletcher's gone to right back, Everett to the left. I'm sure it'll be far more comfortable. It's Hetze and Brown in the middle. They've got an important league game coming up in their fight for the Premiership title against Sheffield United in midweek. Vidic, Sylvester at the moment, O'Shea, and of course Gary Neville, who isn't quite yet ready to return. Here's Boazza. Not by Damian Francis, but well wide of the mark. But every now and then, a warning to United. This may not be quite as one-sided as many would have forecast. Favourites have fallen in recent semi-finals. United now without the key defender really in Ferdinand. Out goes Ronaldo, on the way to that challenge. If he works, saw nothing wrong. Francis. Well, that is a bit of a Hetze. Right kicks. Over 700 games now for Manchester United. A fantastic service he's given to them down the years. The longest serving player, of course, in this squad. Here's Carrick. Much newer face on the scene. Rooney. Glorious skill on the ball, here's Fletcher now. Alan Smith made something out of it. Then Rooney and Giggs, and Rooney! Good save by Lee. That really will have done his confidence. A power of good. Really strong reflex save there from the goalkeeper. Thrust into the limelight here in the absence of Ben Foster, who single-handedly has really kept Watford in quite a few games this season. Not to mention the quarter-final against Plymouth, when he pulled off a series of fine saves. Giggs with the corner. It's another one. Has to come off Francis. As Fletcher was grounded. Giggs to try again. Oof, just a whisker away there from Fletcher. How close was this? The keeper was completely stranded on the other side of the goal. Just did it wide. Darren Fletcher, only inches away from what would have been his fourth goal of the season. Hasn't got one yet in the FA Cup. Almost into stoppage time at the end of the first half. FA Cup semi-final. Most neutrals practically. Chelsea Manchester United final, we shall see. You never know, they could play each other three times in a fortnight. If both make it to the Champions League final as well. I don't say that to Liverpool fans. Apology to those supporting Watford at the moment. They certainly haven't given up hope yet. Rooney. Good challenge. Perfectly tight then. From Carlisle. Stewart. Three added minutes at the end of the 45. Wrong ball from Mark. Brisket was never going to reach that one, but it was a loose clearance by Hense. But Evera on hand to bail him out. Now it's Carrick. Such a tidy pass with the ball. Short this time to Scholes. Was a bit more ambitious, the flag has stayed down. Wayne Rooney on the charge again now. So quick to improvise. He's got an extraordinary football brain, this young man. I'm so sure he was onside though. But no flag, now to go on. And he might have caught the keeper off guard there, had that been on target. From United, Lee, a little unfortunate, and Ronaldo was there just to steer it home. But they still have a chance, he said from the off, it'll be a slim one for us, but while we have a chance, we'll give it a go. That's the message from Aidy Boothroyd. I'm sure he'll be continuing that in the dressing room. But they have it all to do in the second half, trailing Manchester United by 2-1. Welcome back from the Peter Brackley to the FA Cup semi-final. First of the two matches being played this weekend. Watford 1, Manchester United 2 at the halfway point. So his team are still in there fighting. Chelsea and Blackburn to meet tomorrow. At the moment, Manchester United in control of his first FA Cup semi-final. The ground where they've had such a good record in recent times. The last 17 visits here. 13 wins and 4 draws in all competitions. So it's certainly a happy hunting ground for them. away today thus far. Well, they'll give credit to Watford. They are making a decent stab at this. Back on level terms through Buazza after Rooney's opener. But almost straight away, that goal cancelled out by Ronaldo with a second for United. The ball back at the driving seat. No foul given here. Much of the dismay of the Watford fans. Got the hold in. Brisket, the Hungarian, has got down. Finished there by Hanse. Oh, I thought he got too much of the ball there, the Argentine. Certainly got the map. Semi-final. Only their second in 20 years. Determined to put on a show. Andy Boothroyd's team. Whatever the final outcome. They've only won two of their last eight competitive games. The one against Portsmouth in the Premiership. And of course against Plymouth in the previous round of this competition. It's been really hard ground for them lately. Hope when the shot from Buazza, they simply flew past Edwin van der Sar. Some measure of success too from set pieces so far. We've heard it out off. I'm sure they will see that as a viable route to goal in this second period. What they don't want now is the injury to such a key defender as Jay DeMeritt. Tangling here with Alan Smith. Could do with that. Such excitement at Old Trafford at the news that Ronaldo has ended speculation that he might be moving to Spain, to either Real Madrid or Barcelona. Of course, have been coveting him so strongly. The news is he's agreed a five-year deal now. Something like over £30 million will be coming his way. And they might be wearing Manchester United. They just wanted to make sure they kept him. How important he's become to the Red Devils. It's better to believe he can go on to become one of the all-time greats. Up there with the likes of Best, Law and Charlton. And of course, Eric Cantona. Very warm afternoon in the Midlands, but that will take its toll later in the game. What we'd like to see. Chance of winning the ball. Tomas Prisket, who is a Hungarian international, rather in and out of the team since coming to Watford. He's going to get the ball ahead of Darius Henderson. And Stephen Cabo, who's on the bench. A challenge here by Darren Fergio and Paul Rio Ferdinand in the first half for United. So here's Gavin Mann. Be looking for the likes of Carlisle at DeMeritt. There was some excellent defending again by United. They were lucky to get away with that as Buazza squeezed it just the wrong side of the post. There's a real threat anywhere near the goal these days. Nobody got a tackle in, and he was surrounded then by red jerseys. The London defenders were looking quizzically at each other. Could so easily have been another equaliser from Buazza. Just another reminder to Manchester United, they can't be complacent here against a very determined Watford team. Maybe an inferior one in terms of personnel, but they have unquestionable desire and spirit. Time on Buazza. it so far this afternoon. What an in-cut play here by Watford. Now he went Rooney, lost possession. Surely, not Ronaldo. Stopping passes here with Paul Scholes. Now Fletcher. Should be Lees, and it is. Hasn't passed. Who has his cross? And that and sort of had to deal with it. Deal with it he did. Now it's Ronaldo as the game opens up. He's off on one of those amazing runs, Cristiano Ronaldo. On to Rooney. And then on Smith. Rooney again. To Brown. Then Evra. He's on the score sheet of that seventh goal crash of the road every week. His first strike in Europe. After playing themselves out of difficulties. Move up the lot though, is Smith. It's Mariapa who got caught there. He's lost his concentration. They won't get punished for it. Giggs. Two out on Smith. And then scores, is it? No. Carmel managed to smuggle it away in time. But only just. And it's Prescott showing real endeavour up front. The cross comes Brown. There's certainly no snaps. That was their company ahead of Boazza. Well, it was a full stretch down the side. Boazza's cross was dipping right underneath the bar. This is around 6-5, 6-6, 7 at the side. Really had to extend those fingertips there just to claw it away. Fresh hope for Watford. Still dreaming of a visit to the new Wembley. In the first part of the new era, here's Prescott. Wing by Brown. And it needs the chance to find it right. Giggs. He's got Rooney to his right. Ronaldo way over on the left. And that's secures a wrong option then, right, Giggs. So intelligently. Ronaldo. Not sure that Prescott placed it. That's a good catch up to him and Mariapa. Now they can certainly relish the cushion of another goal here. Just to damp up Watford spirits. As we approach the hour mark. Goals together. It's another corner. Despite his protest to the contrary there, Tommy Smith. A loser in twice. A loser twice in his two previous semi-final appearances. Just a down by Scholes. Rooney. Through though. That's Boazza now. Taking shot too much up the headshot. But he's still on his way until the intervention by Evra. He still out Hetzer's clutches. I thought he'd lost it here. Not away from Hetzer, not only do that, but not from Patrice Evra, who's covering well. Saw the danger. And slapped the door shut. Smith with the corner, hoping for third time lucky there in terms of semi-finals. Finally whacked out by Rooney. I tell you what, they're not defending with too much conviction, Manchester United, which Watford will be sensing, especially on these set pieces. Back in by Stewart. There was clearly an injury to Patrice Evra. Manchester United. The power gone in the semi-final. Turns the ball to United, which is done now for a goal kick. The best thing to do is just to get on with it now. I would argue that what might not have happened. Well, they certainly haven't let it down so far. And what could remain in contention? Out by now. Not so. They are making a fight of it. Something that Watson wants you on the scene. They do have a chance. This is finishing up the line. Whacked away by Fletcher. Smith nowhere near it. And Rooney. At least for that toss. Ronaldo will keep it in. Keep it alive. Maybe set something going here for United. Scholes to Carrick. Certainly not the exhilarating display we saw in midweek. Not the Premiership leaders, and now Champions League semi-finals. Rooney, this is promising. This might have been anywhere, they're not very accurate. As it is, it's up near corner. I don't think he knew too much about it, in truth. And it was sucked pace step by Rooney. It was Mariappa's header. It's kept in by Fletcher. Smith almost on the end of it. Shoots lately, United. Of course, they are missing so many front-line defenders. Here come Watford again now. Building through Francis. And Boatza. And Prescott up with it. Chance for Chambers to curl it over. And Fletcher lost control, and it's Mann! It was Jordan Stewart, rather. The dreams of scoring the whole day as a Birmingham City fan playing on any territory here. Scholes. Say. Scholes. smoothly. Gets with the pass towards Wayne Rooney, who's almost in there. And Smith. Rooney's still lurking. And here is Rooney! And it's 3-1. And is that now going to be the goal you want, though? That takes them through to the FA Cup final. Two for Rooney. Couldn't really get it away, didn't have time to reorganise, whipped it low by Smith, and no one was close enough to Wayne Rooney, who showed such awareness as ever in front of goal. Surely it's going to take a miracle from here, and Watford now to get back into the semi, now that Sir Alex Ferguson's team have the control that they've been seeking in this second half. Wind out of Watford sails. Need to keep their heads up here now, the Hornets. It's a shattering blow for them. So far. on him. He'll protect it forever. You can understand that, really. Such a prodigious talent. Fletcher. Net for Rooney. Now up for Giggs, to Scholes. Build-up. Unselfish work there by Alan Smith to tee it up for Rooney. But he didn't get hold of it. And Watford stay in for the shot. It's a slim chance now, surely. Thank you. to Richard Lee, narrowed the angle, made it tight, made it difficult for him. And did his job effectively enough. team that Watford are running out of steam now. There's no real surprise, they're giving it their best shot. It's always going to be an extremely hard afternoon's graft against this outstanding Manchester United side, for whom the treble at this stage is still very much up. So if we repeat the pass of 1999.
Penalty.
And Fletcher got very hard done by there. Certainly seemed to be intended by Carlo. Carrick's corner. Goals. His kick. He's feeling his way back after such a long time out.
Two. Could be heading for Watford.
kick to United. As Galitza hits the deck in frustration. And Eddie Beaufort is left just to wonder what might have been. At 1-1, suddenly the dream was on. A few tears will be shed now. So they're back in 84, I remember. Lots of tears from Sir Elton John. Chairman at the time. I don't think he's here today. He'll be monitoring their progress with great interest, of course. No question, he's done a fine job, Andy Boothroyd, in very difficult circumstances. We're going to have a new stadium soon, Walker. He's been promised partners for next season. He's told the likes of Marlon King here. They give him money to recruit newcomers. It does look as if it's going to be in the championship, but not in the championship. Big time in this FA Cup semi-final. It's Scholes for United. Looking to deliver the final hammer blow here. Carrick. Rooney. United through to the final. Here is Rooney, Scott Smith up, and Solskjaer with him. And then Michael Carrick to fire it wide. I repeat of his heroics in midweek. Well, it shouldn't be showing too much despair. Always going to be an extremely tough task here against a team of Manchester United's quality. And in the end, they have ended up second best on the day, just as so many thought they would. It would actually be harder than to concede another one now from a neutral perspective. Scholes to Solskjaer and Smith. They need to be careful, Watford. It's Dooley. The juggernaut rolls off, and the double challenge remains very much on course. Manchester United, the red-hot favourites from today's semi-final, are on their way to the new Wembley Stadium. A record 18th final awaits them now on this 4-1 win over the Premiership's Rotherham club, Watford. Two for Rooney, one for Ronaldo, and then Kieran Richardson. The icing on the cake. Watford, for all their spirit and commitment, simply didn't quite have enough on the day. Got it back to 1-1 at one stage. And then slipped aside at the end. That's that fourth goal so neatly tucked away by Richardson. And the relentless march goes on. This exceptional United side, top of the pile in the league, semi-finalists in Europe. And now the dream of another glorious treble is still alive after success at Villa Park, just as so many predicted. For the time being, semi-final. Ronaldo on the score sheet again, that's 21 for him this season. As he celebrates his new contract. It's Manchester United's day again at Villa Park. They've never been beaten here. Remember, in an FA Cup semi-final, and they have extended that super today at the expense of a Watford team, who are surely destined to relegate.